which includes school social workers and school counselors all across this state. And I am proud to be here to represent my mental health colleagues and all they do to keep the children in Colorado books safe, both physically and psychologically. And I'm not proud of the state of Colorado and its consistent choice to underfund education. Aware of the social, emotional, and psychological needs of all our students, and just as aware of the lack of funding to support the necessary and important work we do. They want to ask teachers now to be mental health professionals. You didn't sign up for that. For example, in my district, 5 out of the last 6 years, rates of suicide risk assessments, threat assessments, social service reports, hospitalizations has increased 5 of those years, 29% of high schoolers, 20% of middle schoolers, and 30% of fifth graders report bouts of depression. That's something mental health professionals need to address. And we all know the impact of bullying and trauma in the lives of our students. The increase in mental health concerns is a reality for many schools every day across the state. And while this is the case, many schools don't have the level of resources they need to meet these needs. They might have a mental health professional 1 day a week, and if they're lucky, 2 days a week. And I'm telling you, that is a crime. The choice to underfund our schools affects all students in Colorado, particularly our most vulnerable and marginalized populations, including students of color, LGBTQI students, refugee and immigrant students, and our DACA families. When mental health needs go up, funding goes down. And so I'm saying to the legislators, while this may seem like an obstacle, we must use this as an opportunity to change the lives of the children we serve. It is up to you to walk alongside the educators in this state to make a difference in the lives of the students in this state. Do the right thing.